All right, what's going on, everybody? Thank you for tuning back into the Biz with Dave right here on My Twist Wings Radio with your one and only Rockstar. And like Dave's doing, we got our girl, Nikki from Loving Hip Hop Hollywood, on us right now. Y'all know that she's my favorite because, first of all, we love that you keep it real, Nikki, and you are thoroughly about your business. And we just love how down to earth you are. So welcome to the show.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for having me.
No doubt. So first of all, let me say shout out to you for being a businesswoman and, you know, have going to college and really doing the damn thing, because that's what a lot of people, you know, they say they're about their business, but they ain't really on it. So I got to shout you out on that.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Yeah, you know, it was really hard going to school and working and being in a relationship and doing all these things at once. But I mean, my biggest piece of advice would be prioritize your time, definitely.
Indeed. So do you find it, like, was it very difficult to do at first, like, you know, just trying to figure it all out?
You know what? School always came very easy for me. So it was never, that part I always had down. It was never that difficult. But, you know, it's the time you have between working, personal, school, family. It's that kind of thing that made it difficult, because, you know, you still want to be able to socialize and do these kind of things while you have business going on, too. You have to try to make time for both.
And it seems like you did. You found just the perfect, you know, timing, you know, to do that, you know, especially having a great family supporting you. You know, how was it, you know, like, that your family really supported you with everything that you've done in life?
Definitely. You know, my family's very supportive of everything I do. Even if there's something they think that they don't think it's a great idea, you know, at the end of the day, we're family, so they're never going to turn their back on me. We're just going to, and you know, sometimes I'm stubborn. I do things my way, and I you know, I learn the hard way, but that's life.
Right. And I got to say, I love your mom's personality, and I feel like you definitely have, like, her personality as well. And the similarities, because, you know, she's real. And when, you know, Molly came down to the, you know, your house like that, like, she went straight in for you. Like, Mom, don't do it. Let him, don't, we don't want him to choke out. We want him to eat his, you know, eat his dinner. She went straight in. I was like, yes, Mom. I love it.
My mom, yeah, she's just like a real boss. She handles her business. My mom is like the nicest lady in the world to anybody. Like, she's just so giving. She has a heart of gold, really. She just, anyone needs anything, she's always trying to overextend herself. She's just a great person.
Absolutely. So now, you are on Love & Hip Hop, and the season just wrapped up last night. And it's this, first of all, I've got to say, it's a little crazy. Were you very skeptical about being a part of, you know, such a platform which could be either make or break you? Were you kind of skeptical about it at first?
A little bit. You know, I've never done any modeling. I've never done any, you know, magazine stuff. I've never put myself out there like that. You know, I was a student. I worked in the club, in the back office. My moves are really silent. So for me to come out so publicly with my life, my relationship, I was a little skeptical about it. Yeah, I was a little nervous.
Right. And you and Molly have been together for now how long? Just in case people don't know, they don't watch the show and they're trying to get familiar.
About 2 years on and off. 2 years.
Oh, wow.
Almost. Yeah.
And you guys met from, like, how'd you guys initially, like, meet up?
Actually, a friend introduced us. One of my friends, she introduced us, and we kind of hit it off right away, and, you know, just stressed out the whole time. I mean, you know, but we got our little breakups here and there, but we always kind of mend our problems.
Right, and we definitely see that, like, with the show, like, you guys have, like, your different issues, especially with Old Girl and stuff like that, Masika, stuff like that, and I've got to say, she's crazy. And I see why you don't like her and, like, her ways and, you know, how she tries to be, like, oh, Miss Right. And she doesn't like to bring up her past, and she, like, throws everybody under the bus. Like, I think that it's crazy. Like, she really is crazy.
Yeah, you know, I don't really like to speak about her because you know, she goes on every interview she can, bashing, and that's not really my style. I'm a little too bossy for that. You don't listen to my will, sweetheart. So you're not gonna get none of my attention. You know what I mean? That's how I think.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. And you know, and I can respect you for that because, you know, when you never did anything wrong to her, and the fact that she thinks that, you know, it's okay to bash people, bash you for, you know, being on your business, like, I mean, I'd be mad too if I were her. She can't get it together.
I was her too.
It's really sad, and hey, to each his own, and you're doing all the right things, and you know, you're helping your family, you know, run the different clubs and stuff like that. Tell me how, you know, a little bit how your family got into that business, because I mean, you guys do have, you know, California on lock, Hollywood, LA with like on lock with these clubs. I'm like, dang, they got every six spot.
My family, this is the thing that really frustrates me, is that a lot of people are like, Nikki, you're spoiled. You don't know what it's like to struggle and all these things. But it's like, I don't think I'm better than anybody, you know? And my family, my right. dad and my mom, you know, they both came from, like, from, my mom's from Casablanca. My dad is from, you know, he's Lebanese. He's from Baghdad. And it's like, you know, my family both have nothing, you know, struggling their whole lives. They started right. everything. They saved up everything and started everything they have together. So it's like, why am I supposed to look down on my family for being successful when they struggled and worked every day of their life? I don't think so. So, you know, when people say stuff like that to me, it's like, I believe family has kids and kids take over the empire. And that's what my brother and sister and I have
exactly.
So I don't feel like it's fair that people try to look down on me because of my family's hard working and what they done.
Right. And that's true. Like, no one should even be looking at you as that type of way because you work. And clearly we see it, like, you know, how you were handling the business with your mom and, you know, you guys went to different meetings like that. Like, we got to see a little glimpse of that. So for anybody to be like, you know, she's spoiled or whatever. So what if you are? You got a degree, you helped your family run the business, and if whatever your parents want to give you because they didn't have that, you know, coming up or something like that, that's their business.
Exactly, and I don't feel like I should be faulted for how hard my family has worked. It just doesn't seem to make sense to me how people think sometimes.
Right, and I let me tell you, I'm like in the same kind of position. Like, my mother had my older brother. When she was 18, so she was still in high school, and she struggled. So when she had me, she was in her 30s, and you know, from her not having anything to her having stuff now, she spoiled me. So I'm right in there with you. Like, I feel your pain. You know, like people saying, you know, they're spoiled. They're spoiled. No, it's not being spoiled. You work for you. And whatever your parent, and you're continuing that legacy, you're building. Now, and I got to salute you, because that's huge right there. Because a lot of people, you know, they will be the spoiled one that they're trying to make you and place you to be, which you're not. Because you get the job done.
I mean, once I have my children, and I'm going to work as hard as I can, because I want to give them and provide them the best life I can that my family provided for me. And that means that they don't have to work as hard as I did or my family has done or prior generations. And that's okay with me.
I was shocked that you and Sid went on a date. Like, that really, that shocked me. I was like, whoa. Like, that, I wasn't expecting that. I'm pretty sure you had already knew who he was, but were you expecting for Tierra to, like, bring Fizz or anything? Like, how did that really play out? Because I'm sure there was a lot that we didn't see on.
Honestly, the episodes you saw are really what him and I filmed. Like, we did not film more than that.
Wow.
It was just the three episodes you saw with Pierre and him, me and him on the date, and then, you know, him and I went to Pierre's performance, but they didn't show that part. Yeah, it's really just what you guys saw.
And how would you say, like, his personality is?
I think Drew is really sweet. He's real quiet. He's a little bit opposite of me because I'm real crazy, you know? So It was definitely, we were kind of opposite. But I think overall he's a great guy. I really respect him. I think he's a great father, and he's a great example of how a man, a young man with a child should be, you know?
Right, definitely. And I was hoping that, you know, you guys would even, you know, still, you know, be dating like that. Because I think you would be able to complete each other in, like, different ways. Like, you would level him out, you know what I'm saying? Like, really help him grow more. So I'm not saying that he's not already a man, but, like, on the business tip, like, there's things that you can show him and vice versa. I was like, oh, I like this. Like, I was confused at first. I was like, I like this. I see why they went on a date.
Oh, yeah. You know what? I think that with him and I, we were both going through a breakup, and I feel like we both just kind of, like, understood one another's situation. So I feel like we were just a shoulder for each other, so we got it, you know?
So now, next week, we're going to see the reunion. What can we expect without, like, giving away too much? Because I know...
Well, I don't want to give away too much, but I will say, you know, shit's about to get real, real.
Like, when you say real, I mean a little bit. Are you saying, like, a little fighting real, or it's going to get, like, crazy with the mouth, like, revealing stuff coming out? Fighting, what kind of...
I think that, you know, like, some things will get revealed. I think I maintain a lot of class all season. You might see a different side of me this time around, you know. You'll see next week. You'll see it.
Well, I gotta say, I'm excited because it looks like it's gonna be like a reunion like we've never seen before. Besides the rumors that we've heard about, you know, that the cast members we won't even speak on. Let they drama, them be them. We already talked about one, and I'm just looking forward to it, especially to see like how people are going to try to come at you because you want Snap and Ryan to play. Say that to Nikki. She told you.
Yeah, I think, you know what, I'm not no hater, so anytime I say something, I'm normally very on point with what I'm saying, and it always ends up being very true.
And I also want to even say, you know, I got to address, you know, the fact that people try to go in on you about, you know, like, I think it was last night you posted a video on Instagram. You were saying, like, how you don't do, like, makeup like that, stuff like that. I gotta tell you, there's no need. You don't need to do it because you're beautiful as is. Without the tour, you got your work done and everything. I'm like, girl, you don't need that makeup. Why are they bothering you?
Right. No, in real life, when I go out day to day, I don't wear it. I don't know how to do it, so I'm not gonna try doing something I don't know how. But I'm comfortable with myself because I take care of my skin, so I'm not really worried about it. So that's why I'll make videos and I won't have makeup on and I really won't care because it's like I'm a real person like you guys do. I don't have to be fabulous all the time.
Right. And for you, has it always been like hard to be like comfortable with the skin that you're in? Or have you always been like, you know what? I'm very confident in who I am. I'm not even going to worry an inch about what anybody says. What I think is a flaw and it's beauty in some way because God made me that way. How have you, like, your whole life been able to deal with, you know, flaws and all?
Well, nobody is perfect. So it's like you just have to, like, embrace the skin you're in, I guess. That's what I would say. Like, my biggest thing that's the hugest turn off is somebody who acts insecure. And I never want anyone to be like, oh, Nikki, baby, you look insecure. She acts insecure. So that's why I'm like, I carry myself with such confidence because it's like, no one's ever going to be able to break me or, you know, make me. That's, I'm just me and that's that. So I always keep my head real high. And I think that I've kind of done a good job at it because a lot of people write me stuff telling me I'm their idol and they love my confidence. And I'm glad that they... See, that's how women are supposed to be. Like, you're supposed to act like you're that bitch at all times.
Now, have you ever encountered, like, with guys that you've even dated, like, them not being so confident of who they are and, you know, what they're about?
Definitely, of course, you know. Of course. I've met a lot of men and, you know, they get a little intimidated, I think, with my life. And it sucks. It's really unfortunate because it's like, we're the same. Like, I don't want a guy to
exactly.
And be like, you know, oh, yeah, you know, you attract high-profile men, and you have all these things, you look a certain way, and start feeling, doubting themselves, because it's like, if I attract all these kind of men and I have all these things and you see who I'm with, which is you, you should know there's something about you that I like. So don't worry about all the other stuff.
You know what? I find that to be, like, very hard because guys don't, I tell you, guys do not like seeing women moving better than they are. Even though it's like a male-dominant industry, entertainment-wise, it's like that men hate that. And I can understand it because there's something, because they lack something and they never go to perfect it once they know what it is. And I think that's a big issue.
Right. I think so, too. And I think men like to feel like, no, it's confusing because men like to feel like they don't want a woman who uses them. They want someone on their level. But I feel like once they get that, they start feeling like they're not a man no more. So it's just confusing.
Mm-hmm. It's definitely confusing. So now, what other things you have going on? Because I know you've got, you started doing some modeling and in different magazines, different shoots, and the picture looks phenomenal. Are you going to, keep doing that and maybe open a club of your own?
Well, as of now, I am actually working on a lingerie line called Nude by Nikki. So that's going to be dropping by Valentine's Day. I'm taking my time with it because I want everything to come out perfect. So I'm definitely taking my time with that. And so you guys will see that coming really soon from me.
Nice. That's exciting. Now, is this going to be through a different company, a distributor, or are you just going out distributing it yourself?
Well, I'm first going to start online, and then I'm hoping whoever wants to pick it up, I can start putting it in little boutiques and things like that. My ultimate goal with it for it to be in, like, Saks and then Barney's, like, the high-end department store. That will be, like, the ultimate goal. But as of now, I'm going to start online. I'm going to see how the business does, and then I'm going to try to have it in some boutiques, too.
Yeah, so what I was saying was, so it's going to be definitely, like, high quality, since you mentioned places like Neiman's and, like, boutiques.
Yes, correct.
That's phenomenal. I'm looking forward to that, Nikki.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.